Let's discuss the motion of a satellite in elliptical path. Here we can see around Earth of mass m e and radius r e, say a satellite of mass small m is moving in a circular path with orbit radius x. So we can simply write here orbital speed can be written as v orbital is equals to root of g m e by x. And we already studied that to escape the satellite from the gravitational attraction, its escape velocity can be written as v is equals to root of 2g m e by x. Now here we can say at the speed root g m e by x, the satellite is moving in a circular orbit because the gravitational force acting on it in inward direction is providing the centripetal force for its circular motion. See, if we consider a situation, if the orbital speed is VO, then the satellite speed VS is increased more than root of GME by X at this position. And if we just analyze the motion of the satellite in its own reference frame, then it will experience the gravitational force in inward direction, and in its rotating reference frame, it will experience a centrifugal force mv naught square by x in outer direction. And for circular motion, the two must be balanced. And here, if speed is more than this orbital speed, then centrifugal force will be more than the gravitational force of attraction. So we can say it will move outside the circular path. Certainly it will leave the circle and it will move outside because the centrifugal force on it will be more than this gravitational force. So here we can state in this motion, if a satellite speed is more than orbital speed, but it is also given that the satellite speed is less than this escape velocity, which is root 2 gme by x. That means velocity of satellite is more than orbital speed, but not sufficient enough for it to escape from Earth's gravitational attraction. So we can state if it is less than escape speed, the total energy of satellite will be negative and it will be in a bounded motion. That means it just came out of the circular orbit, but it will not be able to escape. It will follow an elliptical path and finally reach the initial position and continue this elliptical path only, and it will move on an elliptical orbit in such a way that Earth's center will be located at one of the foci of the ellipse. It is in such a way, as we already discussed in dynamics, that when a particle moves under the influence of inverse square force, which is central, the path of motion is a conic section path. So here we can see it is following an elliptical path. So this ellipse will be followed if the speed of satellite is more than the orbital speed, but it is less than the escape speed. Similarly, say we are given a situation when satellite speed is less than the orbital speed root gme by x. Now it is quite obvious that if speed of satellite is less than orbital speed, centrifugal force will be less and gravitational force will be more. So we can say in this situation, it will come inside the circular orbit if v is less than orbital speed, and it will follow again an elliptical path in such a way that it is in a bounded orbit such that Earth's center will be located at the farthest foci of the elliptical path. You can see when a speed was more than orbital speed, Earth's center was located at nearest foci from the position it was projected. And if we can say v is less than orbital speed, still it is following the elliptical path, but Earth's center is located at farthest foci from the projection point. So we can say these are the two elliptical orbits which can be traced by the satellite if speed at a point from where the satellite is projected is not equal to orbital speed. But certainly if it is more than orbital speed, or even if it is more than escape velocity, then it will escape and it will not come back. That situation we'll discuss later. But you just keep in mind how elliptical orbits are obtained for a satellite in surrounding of a planet. Here, if we just analyze a situation in which you can say if the speed of motion is root of GME by X, then we can simply state, as we have just now discussed, if a speed is less than the orbital speed, the body is going to follow the inner ellipse. And you can simply say it is less than root GME by X, and having such a value that elliptical trajectory will intersect the Earth's surface, like the situation we can see in this picture. And here you can see, if the body is thrown with a speed v, and we already discussed if v is equals to v naught, which is root gme by x, then the body is having a tendency to follow the circular orbit. But if v is less than v naught, or it is less than root gme by x, it will follow the inner ellipse. And here we can state, in case of inner ellipse, if the trajectory of this body will intersect the surface of Earth, then we can simply state the path of Earth will just be an arc of ellipse. It will not be able to complete the ellipse. It will be able to complete the ellipse only when its trajectory won't intersect with the Earth's surface. So here we can state, if this is the speed is having such a value that elliptical trajectory will interact the Earth's surface, and then we can simply state in this situation, path of body, or say if it is a satellite, will be an arc of ellipse as shown. Which we can see here, it will just be following the arc of ellipse, and finally it will land over the Earth's surface.